Sorry, I'm a little distracted because of this Charlie Watts news.
I was just going to say, I just heard it moments ago. Moments ago. So, wow.
Yeah.
That's kind of wow.
Yeah, I mean, I know he was older and his health was failing and he'd already beaten cancer like once or maybe twice before. I'm not sure, but the Stones are like one of my favorites, and this is just
That's a biggie. That's a real biggie.
It's huge.
I know. I mean, I know they were planning on going out with Steve Jordan instead.
Yeah.
Because of Charlie's health, but wow. Yeah. I mean, it's like Charlie Watts. You know, he's been in our lives for 60 years.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. I mean, my whole life and like has. The music he's played on has been around my whole life at some really great moments and some really, really stupid moments in my life too, you know, and it's just, it's like when Neil Peart died, you know, I just lost it, you know,
wow.
It was just, it's crazy.
Let's kick into Charlie, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. We got them. You know what? I always say this and everybody always says this, but at least we have the music. So, you know, that's really what it's about. I hate to start the interview off like this. I'm just...
life, though.
Yeah.
Part of life is passing away from it.
Right, yeah. I mean, there's only one destination, so you got to... You know, it's not a dress rehearsal. This is the show, so you got to make it happen.
Right.
Right? And
that's so right.
You know that just almost better than a lot of people because you have made a lot of music happen in your life.
Well, thank you.
Yeah,
thank
I you. Mean, but, you know, you've been with Foreigner for quite a while, and they're playing over here at Indian Ranch in Webster tomorrow, and we're looking forward to seeing you, and you know, so many hits, so many hits. Can you possibly tell me which one gets the biggest reaction when you go out there and play them? Because, you know, much like the Stones, everybody knows at least one, two, three Foreigner songs.
Yeah. Well, there is no singular one that gets the most reaction every night. I mean, in a way, I Want to Know What Love is kind of a peak in audience reaction, especially because they sing it. And you know, the audience is so loud when we sing that. But there's so many moments. You know, Jukebox Hero usually gets a ridiculous amount of hate, right. Just crazy. Urgent, and you know, there's a lot of stuff. So, what I will tell you is that we're just so pleased at the reaction we get with everything, and you know, never take it for granted.
Yeah, and you must be just so pleased and psyched to be back out and playing live. You know,
we are indeed. Yeah. We are indeed. We're very, very happy to be out here, and you know, we're doing biweekly COVID testing with band and crew. Mm-hmm. We're taking all the precautions we can because. You know, we're seeing some of our peers running into some problems and having to, you know, cancel tours and at least portions of tours. And we are doing our best to avoid that. So we are running a strict regimen out here. But, you know, it's what we need to do to keep rocking. And that's what we plan on doing.
Yeah. And you guys are certainly rocking like 6 months out of this year, pretty much. I was looking at your schedule. You guys are putting in the miles. As usual.
Well, as we always do, we are a touring band when there is touring.
Yeah,
you know,
yes.
You know, took a year and a quarter off, which is, I mean, the longest time I'd taken off in I don't know how many years. So there was that. But, we plan, as long as everything's safe and healthy, we plan on going hardcore from now on.
I want to ask you about, and you've been doing, you guys have been doing this for a while, is working with... youth music programs, whether it's junior high or high school, and this time around, you know, we're working with you on trying to get a high school or junior high choir to help you guys get one on stage to open for you at Indian Ranch. And I know a few years ago when you guys were in the area, I think it was around 2014, 2015, you had the Brockton High School Choir from Brockton, Massachusetts, sing with you. And then recently, I was reading you had. A young guitar player down in Virginia opened the show for you, which it's such a great story. And what was the inspiration for getting involved in youth music programs for you guys?
Well, number one, um, I personally, and this is one of the reasons why I oftentimes am the spokesman for this within the band, I personally am a product of public school music education. I really feel that without my orchestra teacher in junior high and high school, because it was the same guy, without his encouragement, I don't know if I would have, I mean, I think I might have still pursued professionalism, but he really, really, really helped a lot. We're big believers in that. And we also know that with all the funding issues that are happening, especially now with, all the crazy closing shutdowns and, everything else that's going on, schools are having a hard time with budgets. Yeah. So, and oftentimes the first thing to go is the music program.
Yes.
And so we want to do our part. And, we understand that, but we feel that music is very important. I mean, it's been proven that music will improve everything for people. Basically.
Yeah, it just makes life better.
Math, they test better in math, they test better everything else. So we want to help. So we are here to raise money for schools, raise awareness, and do whatever we can to make sure that school music funding doesn't become a product of the past.
Right on. Right on, Jeff. Why aren't you president of the United States? Oh, wait, you already have a pretty awesome job. But still, I mean, we need more of that. Like, people always, I don't want to get too political here, but whenever anybody's running for anything, that's the first thing they say. We're going to help the schools. And then once they get in there, somehow that never happens. But right on, Jeff. That's very true.
Yeah, we are trying to put the proof, our actions where our mouth is.
Yeah, right? Also wanted to ask you, I was reading, you were saying earlier this year, you were saying you guys are actually working on some new music, or were, but you weren't really looking to put out a whole album worth of stuff all at once. You were looking to kind of maybe just put out singles here and there, or maybe attach some new stuff to some other project. Has that formed a little more? Is there more details you can give us on that?
You know what? Likely it's not very changed from when you read it. We're sort of in a not a limbo, but because the touring machine is back up and up again, there hasn't been a lot of movement on the new music since then, but Mick is still pursuing stuff, and so it's moving slowly but surely, but nothing to really report yet.
Okay, well, we're looking forward to it, whatever comes out. And I also want to ask, if I can, maybe a couple of non-Foreigner questions, because
you
wrote my favorite Dokken song. And I'll tell you this, I'm not a huge Dokken fan. And for people who don't know, you were in Dokken for a little while. But you wrote Just Got Lucky, right?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. See, that was one of those songs where I'm not a huge fan of the band, but that song, to me, when it came on the radio, undeniable. I just, stop whatever I'm doing. It's just such a great hook, and it's such a great tune. And
well, thank you.
And then you wrote, like, Into the Fire and In My Dreams, a bunch. I mean, really, I don't know, people could argue this, but really the best parts of Dokken you were involved with.
Listen, it was co-write, other guys were involved too.
Okay, but were there.
I was definitely there, and, Just Got Lucky in particular, I did have a lot to do with. So, thank you. I appreciate that.
Well, I was just wondering if there's anything in the future. I know you're full on in Foreigner mode now, but maybe in the future, anything, I know you guys have gotten together a few times in the past, if there's anything like that coming.
We did do a Japanese reunion in 2016, which was really fun and good. And yes, and we do talk and we do communicate. A lot of the bad blood has kind of simmered down considerably over the years.
Yeah.
George has been doing shows with Don recently. And so, we talk. I mean, I know Don right now is doing his own Dokken record for a German label. So he's kind of committed to that for the next couple years. But you never know. Maybe someday. None of us have said absolutely close the door. That's for sure.
Right.
So if circumstance, time, everything aligns, I know I would love to do one last Dokken record that I feel kind of puts the exclamation point on everything. I think everybody else feels the same way, but we'll see. I mean, it's down to time and everything else.
As a songwriter, musician, a producer, engineer, you've covered all. You do all facets of creating the music. So I have a question for the songwriter part of you, when something comes to you and you're writing a song, do you hear a particular sound like this would be great with Foreigner, or this would be great with Dokken, or this would be great with these musicians or another project? Is that something you decide when you finish a song or while you're writing a song?
Sometimes, well, you know, there is like commissioned writing in a sense,
right.
Like, okay, we're getting together and we're going to write for this. You know, there,
yeah.
There is that.
Yeah.
But when I'm just writing, you don't want to think it too early, because first you want the idea to kind of develop. But a lot of times when you sense where it may be going, then you kind of shift your approach to kind of gear it more towards, like you say, okay, this could be for Dokken, this, you know. So it, there's no one set way of doing it. There's no formulaic mm-hmm. approach. It's just, it's all about instinct. I mean, songwriting is all about instinct anyways. So, you know, you let your instinct guide you. But no question, if you're involved in various projects or whatever, those are going to influence how you kind of dictate moving forward on a song. But the answer isn't as clear-cut as you would probably like.
You're right. Right. Well, I know everyone's different. Everyone writes a song differently.
I have a large palette to choose from. But a lot of times when writing a song, I just write the song and then figure it out from there.
Okay. All right. Well, Jeff Pilson, thank you so much for taking the time. Again, Foreigner tomorrow at Indian Ranch in Webster. Get tickets now. There's a few tickets left, I think. And get there early to see which high school or junior high or youth choir ends up opening for the band. That could be go out there and support your local musicians there. But thanks a lot for taking the time, and thanks for talking about Charlie Watts with me. That was...
Sure, man. Yeah, well, you know, hey, I think it's a wake-up call to all of us, you know?
Right.
It's weird. It's a mortal life we live.
Yeah, right. Yeah, even for the rock stars. All right, Jeff, thank you so much, man.
Well, thank you. Yeah, and thank you so much. That was great. Bye-bye.